Hi, in today's lab, we'll be exploring the principle of buoyancy. The first part of the lab will be mostly be reminding ourselves of what the buoyancy force feels like. Most of you probably have experienced a force either in a bathtub or in a swimming pool. In this case, we have given you a big vat of water and a little plastic container you can use as a ship. You can try this at home, actually. What we ask you to do is to simply feel the force for yourself. So you can put your hand right in there and push it around and ask yourself simple qualitative questions like, what's doing the pushing, maybe, or which way is it pushing? Does it matter if I push fast or if I push slowly, or if I push near the side or in the middle, if I push tilted or not? So just have a little fun with it and put down some observation for yourself. From the qualitative description in part one, the handout will guide you through a simple derivation to reach a more quantitative formula with which you can do some simple calculation with. In part two, we'll apply this formula to identify what tree a certain stick comes from by measuring its density. Here we have a stick that we picked up actually in the Langara golf course. You see that we've chosen a section with a fairly uniform cross section. And also we've marked out 10 roughly equal divisions so that when we put it in the water, we can see roughly what percentage of the stick lies in the water. So we simply dunk this in the water and we can see that at a certain submersion level, it floats and it's in equilibrium. And we can also note by the markings roughly what percentage of the stick is submerged. From that, we can work out the density and therefore identify what tree it comes from. So here's a setup for the last part of the lab. Once again, like part one, we have a big vat of water and the round plastic container for our ship. This time though, we'll be adding a little bit of cargo in it in the form of the weight. And you will see that as we add the weight, the ship will sink more. And using Archimedes Principle, we can find out exactly how much more. So first, notice the ship without the cargo and how much it's the water level and how much it's sunk. And then we can add the weight to the boat, making sure it's fairly even and not very tilted, nice and balanced. And you can see that it has sunk quite a bit more as a result of the added weight. Now, to work out exactly how much, it is important to measure this distance right here from the bottom of the boat to where it hits the water. And it's up to you to figure out the best method how. For more details, you can refer to your handout.